that last shot against France. You have LeBron and KD over on the other side, and I think they're open, but you're taking
you
that
think
shot.
They were open. Yeah. They were 100% open.
What is going through your mind when you're taking that shot? You have what you have, you know, Batum and the other guy all over you, and knowing that KD and LeBron are just fine with you taking that shot.
I wouldn't say that either, because I read body language pretty well. When I watched it back, I got trapped. I threw it to K. Braun was open on the wing, on the swing, but K threw it back to me. So when he did that, that's when your muscle memory takes over. I'm already in motion and do my move or whatever. I see the two guys, but I'm already in rhythm. As long as I get it off, I feel like I'm going to make it. But I see both of them as soon as I'm shooting their hands up, and they both went like this. Like, they didn't expect me to shoot it. I'm sure they were ready for a pass back to the weak side, but as soon as it went in, seeing Bron do the gesture, seeing the guys on the bench, you know, Kay threw his head back, and I was kind of in amazement. Like, that was the beauty of that team, too, because the energy that we showed and the emotion that we showed in the Serbia game on the comeback and down the stretch in the Olympics, like, it mattered to everybody to get that done, and everybody knew the sense of urgency of the moment, and It was a memory for a lifetime for sure. So it's nice the way it finished for me personally, but we don't get there without all 12 guys on that team, and it was definitely something I'll remember forever.